If all you know about dinosaurs comes from Jurassic Park and Jurassic World, you'd be forgiven for thinking they're all hell-bent on eating Hollywood's most delightful actors and occasionally looking sympathetic as we come to realize that man is the true monster. But dinosaurs roamed the Earth for about 175 million years, and you know they must have gotten a few things done in that time. Humans have only existed for about 200,000 years, and we've already created burritos and HBO. With that in mind, here's what you need to know about the dinosaurs. Number 10. T-Rex had 10-inch teeth. Everyone knows that a Tyrannosaurus Rex was a living monster, but it's hard to wrap your head around just how monstrous these things were if you haven't seen a full skeleton in person and all you've had to go on is what you've seen in movies. In real life, T-Rex had teeth that were up to 10 inches long to the root. They were capable of taking a bite that weighed 500 pounds in their mouths at one time. Google says Chris Hemsworth weighs around 220 pounds and Chris Evans weighs 200, so a T-Rex could eat both Thor and Captain America in one bite and still have room for a good portion of Iron Man's 172 pounds. While determining how a dinosaur must have lived so long ago isn't easy, some scientists think the T-Rex might have been a scavenger like the hyena, roaming the countryside for carrion on which to feast. Other evidence has shown that perhaps the opposite was the case and that the T-Rex's imposing size and fearsome jaws were built for hunting like a lion. So, what's the definitive word on how a T-Rex hunted? Well, no one knows for sure, and we may never know. What we do know is that whatever it chose to eat did not stand a chance. Number 9. Wishbones come from dinosaurs. You've probably heard that chickens are one of the closest living relatives to the T-Rex in the modern world, but the practical way in which that could be the case is difficult to understand. They walk on two legs, they have vicious little claws, I mean, what else is there in common? Well, it turns out there's another link between the two. Like your Thanksgiving turkey, dinosaurs like the T-Rex had a wishbone. The furcular bone, the technical name for the wishbone, is unique to birds. They couldn't achieve flight without their chest muscles attached to it, but dinosaurs had them too. The two most famous residents of Jurassic Park, the raptor and the T-Rex, both had wishbones in their chests. So why did a massive lizard incapable of flight need the bone birds use to fly? The working theory is that it supported their chest muscles, allowing them to grapple with prey. Number 8. Brontosaurus was a real thing. For many a year, the Brontosaurus was known to every kid who knew anything about dinosaurs. They were the big ones with the long necks and the long tails. Then one day, someone said, "Well, no, that's not actually a thing." The story goes back to 1879, when the first Brontosaurus fossil was found and named by Athenial Charles Marsh. In 1903, a different paleontologist determined that Brontosaurus was, in fact, the Apatosaurus, which had existed in the literature since 1877. It came first, so Brontosaurus became Apatosaurus. It wasn't until 2015 that there was enough fossil evidence to suggest that Brontosaurus wasn't just a misnamed Apatosaurus, but that it was its own distinct genus separate from Apatosaurus, and so it came blazing back to life, so to speak, as its own dinosaur again. Number 7. The smallest dinosaur was very, very small. Thanks to the over-the-top effects of Jurassic World, we've come to expect all dinosaurs are big enough to, if not swallow us whole, at least dismember us with minimal effort. Sure, they tossed in those tiny Compsognathoses in the original Jurassic Park, but they were mostly just an afterthought. In real life, they were the norm. Most dinosaurs are actually quite small. The real-life velociraptors were the size of chickens or turkeys. The ones we saw in the movie were closer to utoraptors and not typical of most raptors at all. And the smallest of all dinosaurs? Well, that would be the size of a bee hummingbird, about 2 inches in length. In the perfect Jurassic Parkian twist, this tiny guy was discovered in amber, just like the mosquitoes from the movie. The 99-million-year-old fossil was found in Myanmar and features the minuscule heads of this little terrible lizard preserved in golden amber. Even though it was just a preserved head, scientists guess that the creature maybe weighed 2 grams, or about the weight of $2 bills. Number 6. The biggest dinosaur was very, very big. Have you ever wondered how big dinosaurs could get? Well, you need to look no further than the Argentinosaurus and its Titanosaurus or brethren if you want to fully appreciate just how massive these beasts really were. The fossilized remains of one found in 2014 indicate that the animal weighed around 77 tons and was probably 40 meters, or about 130 feet in length. It would have been the largest thing to ever walk the face of the Earth by a long shot, and at 77 tons, it weighed as much as 14 elephants, or about 36 Tesla Model S's. If you ran across an Argentosaurus or similarly sized family members in the wild, you'd have to look out of a seventh-story window to make eye contact with them. This was a big boy in every way. Number 5. There are 700 species of dinosaurs. There are over 340 breeds of dog in the world right now, and over 100 breeds of cat. There are also 36 separate cat species like lions, ocelots, tigers, and so on. Pretty diverse overall. So, how did dinosaurs stack up? There were over 700 different species. That includes 300 genera, along with 700 species, and it doesn't include the flying types or the ones in the sea. Factor in the knowledge that the fossil record is not yet complete, and we keep discovering new dinosaurs every year, and you can safely say there are over 700 of them. That's an incredible diversity of life. When we look back at dinosaurs now, it's easy to forget just how long these creatures were walking the Earth. They were on the Earth 875 times longer than we have been. It's hard to wrap your head around that number. Whole species rose and fell, and new ones took over in their place over entire epochs. It's just so far removed from our day-to-day lives that we lump them all together as though they had all been attendees at the same party. Number 4. Megalosaurus was the first dinosaur. With so many different dinosaur species, there had to be that first one. One person who found it. One fossil that kicked off the whole era of paleontology. That man was William Buckland. The fossil was Megalosaurus. No doubt many people around the world had found fossils for years previously. Reverend Robert Plot had found a massive thigh bone in 1676 and assumed it was from a species of ancient giants, but Buckland's Megalosaurus was the first one that had science applied to its description and understanding. Buckland found the Megalosaurus in 1819, and by 1824 had described it fully, thinking it was an ancient giant reptile. This predated the very word dinosaur, so he didn't have that label to apply to it. He called it Megalosaurus because it meant great lizard, which was an apt name. And since dinosaurs had not even been officially categorized, no one even knew what Megalosaurus was. It was just a big lizard. Number 3. Dinosaurs were warm-blooded. If there's one thing everyone knows separates a lizard like a dinosaur from a mammal like a hyena, it's that the dinosaur is cold-blooded and the hyena is warm-blooded. Except that that's not the case. While the original thinking was that dinosaurs were cold-blooded, that then evolved into a belief that some might be in between warm and cold-blooded, and now new evidence has shown that dinosaurs may very well have been all warm-blooded. While it's common knowledge that birds evolved from dinosaurs, they evolved from one kind of dinosaur, the theropods. That those were warm-blooded isn't too hard to believe. But as we know, there were a lot of different kinds of dinosaurs, and they didn't all turn into chickens. So how can you tell if other dinosaurs were warm-blooded? Science is the friend of the researcher, and there's a way to analyze eggshells to determine the temperature of the organic matter that had been inside of it. It involves measuring carbon and oxygen isotopes. The result of that was researchers determining it wasn't just theropods that were warm-blooded, but sauropods too. Those were the giant long-necked dinosaurs like Brontosaurus. An analysis of another egg belonging to a third duck-billed species also indicates they were warm-blooded. That would have included things like the Triceratops in the warm-blooded category. So even though there is evidence the body temperatures of some would have dipped low sometimes, it's a trait shared by other warm-blooded species as well. Number 2. Mammals and dinos lived together for a long time. Though dinosaurs ruled the Earth for quite a long time before the rise of mammals, these weren't exclusive and separate moments in time. Mammals didn't come from the ashes of dinosaurs so much as they just played second stage during the reign of the giant lizards. Our warm-blooded and furry relatives coexisted with dinosaurs for a really long time, as in about 150 million years. If you were following the timeline there, you remember that dinosaurs existed for 175 million years or so, so mammals were there pretty much the whole time. Alongside mammals were the proto-mammals that had fur and claws and all that jazz, but were still pretty lizard-like in the way that they reproduced. Fossils indicate that these early mammal ancestors had tiny brains, weren't nourished by milk, and probably were born ready to fend for themselves like lizards rather than needing to be nurtured like typical mammal babies. These proto-mammals may have existed as far back as 208 million years ago before the Jurassic period even began. Looks like John Hammond should have thrown in some otters next to the raptors in Jurassic Park. Number 1. Dinosaurs only lived on land. In common parlance, the average person will tend to refer to anything that may have been a giant man-eating or man-stomping monster as a dinosaur. That's everything from a Triceratops to a pterodactyl to that waterlogged Mosasaurus from Jurassic World. But in reality, only one of those things is a dinosaur, and that's the Triceratops. To be a dinosaur, the animal has to have a hip joint that allows it to walk on land. If it doesn't have that joint, it's not a dinosaur. So avian creatures from that time could have been called pterosaurs, but are not, by definition, dinosaurs. Anything that swam in the sea and couldn't walk on land also wasn't a dinosaur. There were 38 genera of mosasaur. They were similar, but not the same. In fact, some of the numerous creatures of the deep, like mosasaur and plesiosaurs and nothosaurs, were barely even related to one another and were not from the same family or order. Today, the only ancestor of those creatures we can point to is the sea turtle, while most just went extinct entirely. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, why not check out another channel I do? It's new. It's called Mega Structures. It's all about mankind's greatest achievements. Please find that link to below. And thank you for watching.